Hi, today the add-on and restoration of this aircraft instrument from eBay. It was, believe it or not, 1 euro. Why? Because the main issue is this. The indicator needle did fall off, and in fact, there is some stuff noisy inside. So I guess it has some mechanical problems. So the goal will be mainly to reattach this indicator, clean the glass inside, and we will go from here. Maybe I will see if I can repair the inside, but maybe it will not be complete. So it is from Intercontinental Dynamics Corporation, Englewood, New Jersey. Maximum allowable airspeed indicator. Serial number 123, made for Falcon 10 aircraft. So here we have a pretty serious multi-pin connector and the two static and dynamic air pressure inlets. And a plane passing above. Okay, so I have an issue here with this button because the set screw is completely stuck inside, and it is where the Allen size. I haven't got this. It is Imperial probably, but very small, and I haven't got this. But maybe it will not be necessary to remove this button. So for opening it, we have two screws at the back. In fact, I was interested because I have another instrument of the same kind, which is new old stock and which I cannot open because it is still factory sealed. But this one, but finally it is not exactly the same model. It looks very similar, but mine doesn't have so many contacts at the back. It just contacts for the backlight. So two screws on this backplate. There is something interesting about it is that half of this label is glued on the air. It is quite weird, so it is damaged because if you press on it, of course, you will bend it and tear it. Quite weird. Why they didn't make a label somewhere here? Not sure. Okay. So now I can case, and yes, first thing first, here it seems we have a loose piece. In fact, we have some axis bearings here, so probably it is supposed to come like this, but it looks like it is too short. So I may be missing a part here. So I will probably not reinstall this piece. Apart from this, first we can see we have a lot of electronics in this one. Three synchro motors, one over kind of motor here, and two circuit boards with here look this at these guys. It seems we have some hybrid circuit. So, first I will take care of this indicator to repair, and then we will try to have a look at the electronics. So, I guess I will zoom a little bit. Oh, by the way, this is because one of my videos was re-uploaded by someone with removing the sound. Just for profit, so I did do a YouTube copyright claim. They did remove a video. It was a channel re-uploading a lot of videos, as always. So you can reuse parts of my videos to illustrate something and or made an ad for my channel, of course. But re-uploading a complete video without mentioning the source. For to try to get only views is not very fair. So what do we have here? I want to access this front piece here. It looks like I have screws by here, but there is these things which are attached to the front. So first I need to remove them. And for this I will need to undo this wire ties. 1, 2. So I have one screw here. Try to not lose anything, and maybe, maybe not, I will be able to turn this thing. I think I will need some help. Excuse me. For instance, from some help from a little Allen key, like this. Yes, it was pretty right. And now I can undo this piece. Here we are. I have another one here, exactly the same thing. In fact, I did already investigate a little bit this instrument before I do the video, because it seemed to be quite complicated, but in and I was worried about this button here, which is not possible to remove. But so here we have some oxidation problem of the aluminium. It is all whitish. Here is the thing back here. Okay. Oh, this one was loose already. Second one. And third one. It will allow to separate more or less the electronics. There is a big wire harness at the other side, which cannot be disconnected. Okay, so we have this wire here. We have one connector here, which I can undo. And now I am very annoyed with two things. So first there is this wire, but there is also this pipe. And I would like not to cut the pipe to the capsule here. So I guess I will try to unscrew this mount. Yes. And in fact, the parts connected to this thing, it was connected with these little pieces here to these notches here to transmit the movement. But as I cannot reattach this piece because I'm missing something, anyway. Looks like I have also this screw to remove. This thing is is very complicated. And look at this. Yes, surely enough, white dust. So I may be able now to remove the thing. Maybe. In fact, I have to move it at this side or this, like this maybe. No, but I am very annoyed because of these pieces here. So will it be possible or not? I do not know. This piece cannot be removed because it is riveted in place. And here, this is one single part. So I cannot do much here. And yes, it is quite a mess now. So I guess it will be No, in fact, I cannot. There is no way this thing goes under this part here because it is too. Or maybe. It is just very, very tight, in fact. And I have to find the sweet spot. If not, I will cut the pipe. It is a little bit sad, but anyway. Maybe like so. No. Okay, anyway. This thing is not to be reused again and ever. So, I will cut the pipe, I guess. Somewhere around here. What to use for it? I will use a little saw. If I use a saw, I will not. I keep the possibility to resolder the thing because it is not. It will not obstruct the hole. It is copper, so it should be quite easy. Just if you use the side cutters. There is no way you don't block the hole. Try not to cut my fingers at the same time, if possible. We are almost here. Maybe now I can do this. Yes, here we are. Okay. So it was quite a mess, this thing. So now I have this piece, which is more or less useless anyway. So I am wondering if I will reinstall it at all or not, in fact. And in this case, maybe I will shorten this pipe somewhere around here. I will see. Okay, now that it is done, I will cut this wire because I want to be able to flip it totally out of the way, like so. And yes, let's get rid of this pipe for good. It is insane as you can change your mind. Let's see, a little bit of time. Anyway, it is not going to be reused ever. Okay, it will be much easier like so. Now we can try to. So this is really a cute little copper pipe. And now we can try to access this front piece to repair the needle indicator. I have a few more screws to undo. And I guess this spacer, yes, little spacer that comes off at the same time. So, very tiny washers, probably for precision spacing of a thing. One last here. Here are the backlight bulbs. And it looks like we are good. Okay. Now, yes, all right, it is all going as expected. So we have a dial, we have a little bulbs which can be removed. There is this little cover on the, above them. And very tiny bulb, probably. You are just supposed to pull on it. It is fine, they did include vegetal covers. Okay, so we have a needle that needs to be reattached, but before this, I will clean a little bit. I guess it will be quite necessary. So I will clean it with some duster wipes. It may be good enough. Because there is quite a lot of dust inside here. So this must be good enough. And try to clean the dial. Sometimes you have very nasty surprises when you clean dials, because in particular on old equipment, pre-World War II, something like this, the paint was water soluble on the dials. Of course, if it is radium paint, it is even worse. But most of the time, the paint is water soluble. So there is this ring here that comes off. It is some offset indicator. I will probably remove it for now. And now I have to figure out how to reinstall that needle after a little bit of cleaning. So it looks like the center axis is here. Yes, and in fact the needle did go away because there is a... looks like we are missing a bearing here at the back, and this piece is free to move, and it will move the center. It is very tiny, I'll show you if you will see it, but the axis here in the middle, and it is why maybe with a shock or something like this the needle was pulled off. So now I have to try to keep it in place and press at the same time on here without breaking anything. So at least now it is in place. Maybe even a little bit too much because it is rubbing. It is better now. And in fact this front dial seems not very flat. Not sure here what is happening, but the goal was just to reinstall the needle anyway, so we are good. So I can reinstall this piece, whole piece, like so. So how the backlight works, we have some white paint inside here, and probably two pieces of glass doing some kind of light diffusing. Yes, it is why you have a screws at the front here. It is to allow to separate this this piece, but I cannot do it because of stuck set screws. Okay, so at least it will look better on display. So I will re-screw this back in place, and we will have a look at the electronics. Okay, it was not that easy, but it is installed. There's some light issues here. So we now have a look at the electronics. So as you can see, the needle is reinstalled. Looks quite okay. So we have a very complicated assembly with three of these induction, position, servo, control, something. And as you can see, it is quite unusual to have orange caps on this device. Usually they are blue. Really not something habitual here, quite weird. Not usual, yes, it is a word. So, I am taking the opportunity to remove some of the dust. So what else do we have in here? We have terminal board here. This little tiny connector, which seems quite pointless because in fact, yes, it seems it will allow you to replace the electronics package, but all the wire harness is attached to the frame of the instrument. So about the electronics, we have a stack of two PCBs, which now I should be able to undo completely to have a better look at it. In fact, you cannot undo them when it is installed on the instrument because the screws are not possible to reach. And again, it seems it will be quite a pain. We have, you see, even with the screws, so it looks like I need first to undo these little screws which attach the two PCBs together. There are two of them. And then I should be able to, no, three of them. Quite annoying, this thing. Very, very time consuming to work on this. And now I have better access and I can pull the complete assembly. And look at this. No, it is okay, but I need to remember. So the yellow transformer is near this plug. Okay. Because if not, when you reassemble this, it will be quite easy to flip it around and be annoyed after. So this one is very hard to undo. All imperial screws in this thing. And a few mortars on this one. And we may be free. Yes, at least. So here you have the bulkhead of the instrument. It is some kind of die-cast metal, yes. So this air plug is connected to the instrument case directly. And the other one so was connected with a pipe I did cut to this aneroid capsule. Interesting, and you can see the connector here, back of the connector. Okay. So about this electronics, yes, look at this. We have a very nice hybrid circuit made by Beckman Helipod Division, and you know what? It looks like it is socketed. I will not pull on it, but it looks we have some kind of sockets down here. And also these ICs, round ICs, are socketed. And also the transistors. No, excuse me, there are no ICs. They are relays made by Teledyne. So very, very miniature relays, quite insane. We have little transformer here, more relays here. 747 IC here. And at the same time, I have a dead code of 1974. But I see here another date code of 1972. It is quite interesting. So this hybrid can is golden on the side. Model number 866. It seems trim pot here. I am a little bit zoomed too far. Gold silk screening on the PCB on the back. Some bulge capacitors probably, some flat flex connecting the two boards together, and hard soldered. We have sticker on here which says Hansley Electrip. quite interesting. And on this side, we have more transformers. We have one more 747 LHC semiconductor here in a nice socket. It looks like this socket, in fact. Yes, it is not plastic, it is ceramics. So, spare no expense here. A whole bunch of trimmers. And what else? Yes, two ICs, which it is completely impossible to read the model numbers. With, in a weird low profile socket, as you can see, but it seems they are socketed. Yes, so you could pull the ICs, quite interesting. Some power resistors here, well, power, higher power resistor. And of course, the most interesting piece is this nice hybrid circuit. I was not expecting this at all in this instrument, so it is a nice surprise, in particular for one hero. So now I will put this back together as far as I can without including this scrap parts. Okay, we are almost done. I will try to zip tie this wire harness. It is not the original wax thing, but it will do the job. In particular, as it is going nowhere, it is not flying again, so not the issue. Maybe I can just put one of them. Yes, it will be enough. And this side, I have a loose wire here. This is not a too big deal. I will put this in place like so. And what I will do also is to attach this, try to zip tie this shaft for the indicator, the needle, in order to avoid having it moving too much and damaging the dial background, because it looks like it is rubbing against the dial. And it is free to move also, so it will be quite annoying if it is never in the same position when I move the instrument. So the trick is to have it where I want before tightening the zip tie. Let's say it is good enough. And this, like so. Well, it is not too bad. Maybe I can try to turn this again. I will keep this like so. Oh, it did move. This is totally not airworthy, guys, but you cannot use it on an airplane for sure. But at least the needle is indicator is reattached. Can I try to turn it? Yes. A little bit more. Okay, we are good. And it will not turn by itself. Okay. We are even very, very nice. Okay, so this is great. Oh, shit, I have an extra washer. Now, I can put back in place this cover. By the way, we have a sticker here from the AIR LN Air Motive Incorporated in Oefdorp, the Netherlands. But there is no date written on it. And it looks like I am missing a seal here, some kind of O-ring. So, last step is to reattach this back plate. And this is quite weird how this back plate is made, really. Bigger stainless steel washers. But now I like to have a standoff here to keep the things from moving around. Quite well designed. We have all in the screw for security safety wire. In fact, you can tighten these screws a lot, and you end by having the case entering the lip here. When you tighten completely your screws. Interesting. Here we are. So this is still working. The inside is quite decently clean and it is back together. There was no need to remove this. Okay, and I have some extra screw parts. So in guess this one is quite pretty. I may put it on display after a little bit more of cleaning of the outside here, but it should be good. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.